Dear friends, the 16th century literature is incomplete without the name of a great monumental writer called William Shakespeare. Though we know that Shakespeare is a great dramatist, his contribution to the field of poetry is very significant. William Shakespeare, as a poet, tried his hand at sonnets. Shakespearean sonnets are a very significant contribution to English literature. Shakespeare, apart from plays, has written 154 sonnets. We generally read his sonnets in terms of numbers, and it is believed that Shakespeare wrote 154 sonnets altogether. We read his sonnets not only in English but in different languages in the form of a translation also. Shakespeare, apart from writing sonnets, wrote two significant narrative poems. His major contribution to poetry lies in two narrative poems. Venus and Adonis is one narrative poem, and another is Lucrece. Venus and Adonis and Lucrece are two long narrative poems that deal with love, hatred, incest, friendship, immoral love, etc. Shakespeare tremendously visualized the effect or the impact and the repercussions of immoral, illicit relationship and sexual obsession also. Venus and Adonis and Lucrece are two long narrative poems that deal with these impacts of illicit and immoral relationship. These are two narrative poems. Basically, Shakespeare's poems, whether narrative or sonnets, are dedicated to his two friends. One is to Earl of Southampton, another is to Earl of Pembroke. Two earls, royal family members, are closely associated with the name of Shakespeare. Let us look at Shakespearean sonnets. Shakespeare altogether wrote 154 sonnets. His sonnets are divided in terms of themes. All the sonnets are divided into different groups, because they are concerned with different themes. Shakespeare wrote on all kinds of subject matters under the sun. It is friendship, love, hatredness, affection, beauty, jealousy, immorality, revenge, intrigue, illicit relation, etc. Morality, ethics, immorality, all these aspects of life, various characters or behaviors, emotions of human beings are the source of the sonnets of Shakespeare. Friendship, love, affection, beauty, immoral relationship, hatredness, history, etc. are the major themes in Shakespeare's sonnets. Shakespeare spent so many sonnets on the theme of friendship. The old age versus youth, beauty versus ugliness, moral versus immoral, love versus hatredness are various subject matters that we can see in Shakespearean sonnets. Shakespeare is basically the man who studied the essential human nature. When we say nature, there are two kinds of natures. One is external nature and another is internal nature. Shakespeare is concerned with the internal nature of human beings. The eternal versus temporariness, the permanency versus temporariness, or the human versus nature are the constant themes in Shakespeare. Shakespeare throughout his sonnets followed one metrical form, that is away from Petrarch. Shakespeare followed AB AB, CD CD, EF EF, GG. The four lined three stanzas and a couplet is a common format in terms of rhyming patterns of Shakespeare. Shakespeare's sonnets are almost written during 1592 and 1609. Almost all his poetry is produced during this period, and they are very rich in their subject matter, because within 14 lines of a poem, Shakespeare tried to give scope to a tremendous thought, whether it is friendship or love or hatredness or immoral relationship, but they are all a source of thinking for the human beings. Shakespeare could make the human beings think, think and think again and again after reading his sonnets. Each line of his sonnet will definitely give rise to a new way of thinking. One or the other line in every sonnet is thought-provoking, that will hold the entire sonnet and a reader together. This is, in terms of subject matter, what we can think of Shakespeare. And Shakespeare's universality is in his writing, because there is no field that is untouched. There is no subject matter or theme that is untouched by Shakespeare. These 154 sonnets that are a contribution in the field of friendship, love, hatredness, jealousy, sex, obsession, or the history, ruins, or past and present, or legal matters, or even his personal love, are a subject matter for every individual to think of what happens to human beings and how a human being can overcome his misery or his defeat or his suppression through reading Shakespeare's sonnets. His sonnets are basically a guiding spirit to the depressed human beings who are facing the difficulties or sorrows of life. Thank you.